giving all praises to God who is the head of my life, to Reverend Poole, to Reverend Booker, to our deacons, members, friends. My name is Sister Malone Johnson. And I am here to expound on our theme, Women of God Standing Strong and Moving Forward. Coming from Proverbs, the 31st chapter, 25th and the 26th verse. The 25th verse says, strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. Right? The 26th verse says, she openeth her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. Right? Chapter 31 in Proverbs talks about the strength, the care, and the kindness of the woman, the desirable woman, the marriage material woman, the qualities of this woman, these women are discussed in verses 10 through 31.
Praise the Lord.
This proverb gives us a good example of how a woman should be.
Right.
We know that we have to be strong, but verse number 10 says, who can find the virtuous woman? Virtuous meaning high moral standards, righteous, pure, exemplary, saintly, angelic. For her price is far above rubies.
Amen.
She is of strength. She is not weak or easily swayed. But through all those things, she remains kind and dignified. She is trustworthy. And someone her husband can bear all things to, as verse 11 says. Verse 12 says, she will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She is a worker.
All right.
She takes care of her household. She cares for her family, all while taking care of herself. Verse 17 says, she girded her loins with strength. Strengthens her arm. She prepared herself daily for what was in store. It simply meant she got the job done.
Right.
A story I have that is near and dear to me is from my claimed godparents, Freddie and Eva James. One day, we had a discussion on marriage and wifely duties. And my godfather told me that he has not ever seen his wife not made up. Meaning, when he got up, she was already dolled up and had prepared breakfast and had already either cleaned the house or cleaned the room or two and prepared for lunch and or dinner. And I said, shoot, not me. And he said, maybe that's the reason why you're not married. Something I can say that I've excelled in. But after that day, I thought about everything we discussed. And the whole time that we talked and debated, Mama Eva was either cleaning up the kitchen from the things that we had already eaten and tore up or whatever we did, and she was just, or she was just sitting there quietly, smiling, or studying a Bible study lesson, or she was recapping a Sunday school lesson, or she was just tending to the grandkids. And I said then, verses 20 through 25 discuss the women and their charity, and her charity. How much do you give of yourself? How much do you give away? I'm an avid volunteer. I work for a job that promotes us to volunteer as much as we possibly can. As a woman of compassion, we have to pride ourselves in reaching out to the poor and less fortunate, or just wherever there is a need.
Yeah.
By doing this, she is bettering someone's day, someone's future, or inspiring them to do the same. Verse 25 says, strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come.
Right.
Through it all, gain the respect of others and inspire.
Amen.
In the past few years, I have noticed a change in myself. When people are negative around me, I flee. Especially if it's a woman. We have to watch how we speak or how we can be perceived. Verse 26 says, she opens her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. As a child, we learn sticks and stones break our bones. Words can never harm us. But to me, that's untrue. Because words can cut you. Words from a person that you have respect for can stab you. We have to always be mindful of how we speak to others. Proverbs 18, verse 21 said, death and life are in the power of the tongue. On this Women's Day, I encourage us to continue to display the characteristics of the virtuous woman. Virtuous meaning V for the Lord your God is the one who goes with you to fight for you against your enemies to give you victory. I now therefore hearken unto me, O ye children. For blessed are they that keep my ways, hear instruction, and be wise and refuse it not. Or receive, I pray thee, the law from his mouth. Lay up his words in thine heart. No temptation has overtaken you except what is common to mankind. And God is faithful. He will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. But when tempted, he will also provide a way out so that you can endure it. Oh, as an earring of gold and an ornament of fine gold, so is a wise reprover upon an obedient ear. You trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. Stand. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the days of evil come, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything, exhausting yourself, you can stand. For Christ also suffered once for sins, the righteousness for the unrighteous, to bring to God. He was put to death in the body, but made alive in the spirit. He rose so that one day we could rise.
Amen.
Therefore, we are women of virtue who have obtained victory through following instructions received from God's word, toiling through all temptation by obedience and understanding trials and tribulations, by suffering yet standing on his promises. Thank you for your listening ear, and may God continue.